Invasive mussels are very harmful to the environment. They also pose very significant economic and logistical issues to water managers, recreationists, and local communities.
Invasive quagga and zebra mussels clog our hydroelectric facilities, irrigation systems, as well as create other aquatic problems in our ecosystems. This reduces efficiency and increases our maintenance costs.
They are very prolific. Each female has the ability to lay 30,000 eggs per breeding cycle, and so in an environment where they do not have any natural enemies or natural diseases, their numbers exponentially grow.
Quagga and zebra mussels were introduced into the Great Lakes in the 1980s. They infested that area and have spread from there since then to throughout the United States. Reclamation's first experience with mussels began in 2007 when they were detected in Lake Mead, and we've been dealing with the issue ever since. Namely, we believe that there's mussels just about in every watershed in the United States outside of the Columbia River Basin.
On the Columbia River system, which is one of the last quagga or zebra mussel-free areas in the country, we estimate that those costs could reach $500 million a year.
Mussels can also dramatically impact recreation. Their shells can degrade swimming beaches. Boaters face increased requirements and costs to have their watercraft inspected and decontaminated. And they also face limited access to water bodies, which can end up impacting the local economy.
Currently, no known broad-scale application for open freshwater exists to eradicate mussels. Could we attempt to control them in terms of their impacts on infrastructure through new novel coatings to limit what they can establish upon, as well as cleaning of pipes regularly to limit their impact?
The problems that we have with these organisms is that they are filter feeders and they sense when a toxin comes into their environment. So they will shut down and they will stop filtering. So if you're going to use something like chlorine, you have to put large volumes of chlorine into the water over a long duration. It's extremely expensive and it isn't 100%. It's very hard to eliminate them with the high fecundity, then they're reproducing, and it isn't very long before they overwhelm the system again.
So Reclamation is seeking innovative solutions for the complete eradication of quagga and zebra mussels from lakes and reservoirs. The ideal solution for this prize challenge would be a treatment that is very specific to invasive mussels that doesn't harm other native or endangered species. And it's really important that treatments are environmentally responsible, they're able to be scaled to large water bodies, and they're cost effective.
I'm excited about this prize competition because I think it actually gives us more possibilities for future control. Reclamation has spent quite a bit of money trying to research control methods, and we've had some success, but again, nothing has been 100%.
Well, I'm excited about it because I am from the Columbia River Basin, and we are extremely interested there in prevention and trying to keep the aquatic invasive species out of our system. And so to the extent that we can do anything to promote that, I'm all for that.
For this prize challenge, we're partnering with experts with the USGS, the US Army Corps of Engineers, and Malloy & Associates. So these partners have valuable expertise in the field of invasive species, and they're very interested in finding a solution that will benefit a variety of agencies.